outside.
Chief Keef. Chief Keef brought out Lil Reese to perform on stage with him. They performed a track that they had together.
People say that him and Lil Reese only came together to do this show. Lil Durk did a big shout out to King Von saying RIP. He had the crowd say his name. He also shouted at D-Fit. He wrote on Twitter RIP to both of them. But him and Lil Baby, ever since the King Von situation, him and Lil Baby is now this big thing, and they're the biggest thing going, and they're getting all these numbers and all these views, and they have this album, and now they're performing at the Rolling Loud and stuff like that. And it's like, it all looked like it was staged, all like it was staged and planned to where it is right now. And we are seeing it right now, because most of the time we don't see the stuff that happens behind the scenes, but this is what actually happened. There is a business plan put into progress, and that's what they did, and now they've accomplished that. And him and Lil Baby is like the biggest stars, and they're getting all these awards and stuff, and they're performing here and they're performing there, and you know, they got the song of the summer and DJ Khaled and all that. All this stuff wasn't a coincidence. It was meant to happen. Plans was put into place, and this is why we are seeing this kind of success from the both of them, from him and Lil Baby. Don't be surprised if a deluxe album comes out with him and Lil Baby.
Track. So Track, who was King Von's manager, who's come out and said that he's no longer manager, and he actually signs artists to his label 100K Entertainment. He did a performance yesterday at the Rolling Loud. This is a video of him here. It looks like a completely different section, because I was watching it as well, and then I was kind of getting confused. But then the stage right here, it kind of looks really, really different to the actual Rolling Loud. But then he tagged Rolling Loud, so I feel like they probably had two different stages. Looking at this video, it is a bit unexpected, because I thought he's not a rapper, but then he was a rapper from the past, this and that. He's performing, like, is he a rapper now? Is he progressing? Is he going down the rapper route? You know, he has a show, he has a podcast and all of it with him and Juice the Pug. You can find that over there. Moo Wop posted this asking people to tag their artists, as he's trying to get a tattoo done of King Von, a portrait on his neck. He said that he wants something else as well on the other side. He was at the Rolling Loud with Lil Durk. He posted a video of him on stage. Probably him, Lil Reese, and all of them, they all meet up and all. Tory Lanez was brought up by DaBaby. People were saying that he was trolling Megan Thee Stallion, bringing out Tory Lanez. Something is going on where they are now doing this to her, to the public and stuff like that, knowing that it can literally affect her image and make her look bad, and that's what they're doing. They are trying to expose her. He played a record with him and her before Tory Lanez came out. He played a record with him and her after Tory Lanez left. Everyone liked Megan Thee Stallion's performance, because she played all the songs that everyone liked and stuff like that, and her energy and everything. But I find it so crazy that she performed before DaBaby, and then DaBaby was next. It's like, I feel like that lineup, it wasn't a coincidence that she performed. He brought out Tory Lanez and all that stuff. I just think it probably was a viral moment, to be honest with you. It probably just was about promotion and clout. Because, you know, Megan and Sarah and the baby have this issue. So why are they putting them before and after each other to perform? It just seems like it was all set up and staged. And then throughout the performance, someone threw a shoe at him. The baby. Literally, they threw their shoes at him. Then we have someone on Twitter claimed that it was them, posting a picture of their shoes, this picture right here, and it was just crazy. Like, DaBaby was so upset on stage. He was like, who threw that shoe at me? He looked like he didn't even know what to do, because it was so unexpected. It was actually a laughable moment, you know, because he tried to shade and he tried to do all this stuff, and then people ended up taking the piss out of him, and people said that he's going to hell because, you know, he brought out Tory Lanez. And I noticed on stage as well, like, most of the times Tory Lanez's mic was cut, couldn't even say much, and he couldn't even hype the crowd up to see if the crowd's gonna boo him or if they're going to praise him. So that's what I thought was a bit funny. Track, and also they're saying that Track was holding it down for YMW Melly. That's why he was performing for YMW Melly, holding it down. And I mean, to be honest with you, like, if that's what they're saying, then that's it. But it just looks like he is actually a rapper, and he comes across as he wanted to be this rapper, and he kind of looked like if he was comfortable in that position. So Lil Uzi, what they did to Lil Uzi as well, they did not let him stream on set, and they cut Megan Thee Stallion. Stream Lil Uzi's performance live. They didn't stream Lil Uzi's performance live. You had to go to a separate link and go to Rap Nation in order to watch Lil Uzi's performance. He performed, but they didn't stream it live like they did everyone else, and they cut Megan Thee Stallion in half.
let Lil Uzi perform. They didn't let Lil Uzi stream live. And people are not happy about it because people is like, well, they could do anything they want and stuff like that. And it's Roc Nation. They took an L and they're talking about they're taking L's. They did not like that. They did not have Lil Uzi perform like they should have done for this reason that just, you know, appeared behind the scene. All of a sudden, this didn't happen and, you know, nothing was happening. And, you know, he was there, he turned up and everything to be there. But all of a sudden, you know, exactly, but she came up and they're not letting him perform. They didn't read to anything. All they did was put up this message on the screen saying that Roc Nation wants people to go somewhere else. All Lil Uzi's fans go somewhere else and watch it. And then this article is calling it a business move. They're saying it was a business and marketing move that they done did to have all the fans that was literally watching online go and stream and sign up something and pay for something. And then that's how they're making it money. And that's how they end up making all this money out of Lil Uzi. At the same time, while upsetting other people that actually likes Lil Uzi and wasn't expecting to see that live stream. And then they was hit with this message right here. Was telling them to go and stream somewhere else and go and do this and go and do that in the space of a time, and why they were streaming Uzi on the stage. It just doesn't make sense. This is what they do to take money out of people's property. I mean, you know, everyone's performing, and people also said that Lil Uzi's performance was actually better than the baby, because, you know, the baby, he was doing all this stuff and he was there for the mess and everything, and he was acting like a girl. I mean, you see all the stuff the baby has, and, you know, he wears the wigs and everything on all these videos, so he's acting a part. He was playing a part, and he played this part again for a business move, a business strategy. That's what he did with the Tory Lanez situation. And then Tory Lanez is dropping the song with him and Kodak Black. He's dropping the video today with him and Kodak Black, so that is going to do something else. And he might have a part in there where, you know, he's taking shots at Megan and all of it. But that's what they are doing for business. It's all business move and money, and they are going to make a lot of money out of this. That's why they continue to do stuff like this. And people is like, you know, people is like, what the hell, what happened to the link? Why have we got to go there? Why have we got to do this? No question, no point asking questions, because you're just missing the show. Get your bank card, get your bank card, sign up somewhere, go to audition, go there, do this, do that, and then find the link where you can actually watch it. Them doing that, and little baby, and the baby, and little baby, and, you know, little Dirk and all of it, everyone on that stage, I feel like had a strategy and had a move. Like what happened with Corey Lee, like what happened with Corey LeRae. Even though no one turned up to her music, that still went viral, and guess what, she's still making money because she's the most popular person or something like that on the internet. It's so weird in the industry, but that's how it works, and she's like one of the most popular person right now on the media. But no one's listening to her music, no one, literally everyone was just standing there, and people were just like, you know, just she's staring, and she's doing the most, and she's trying to get people hyped and stuff, but no one is listening to it. And there's a reason for this, because what you see on the internet,
she said the other day, 500k for a verse, no album out. I'm still confused because no one is actually listening to her music. No, everyone's just standing there, everyone just standing, and this is what she did. I think at this point it's some marketing strategy, and they are pushing her, making it to look like something that is not, presenting all these numbers and stuff, and she calls herself the most viral person in the world. And when we get in real life and everyone's actually standing there, like literally thousands of people just standing there just watching, as she's the only one that's moving, it is weird. And this is where reality comes in.